Student friends, in yesterday's lecture we studied the amplitude modulation as an analog modulation, where we have studied that amplitude modulation is the process in which amplitude of the high frequency carrier wave varies in accordance with that of instantaneous amplitude of the signal to be modulated. Means here the signal which we want to communicate, it is superimposed on the high frequency carrier wave and then it is transmitted from transmitter towards the receiver. We studied the mathematical analysis of amplitude modulated wave. And we concluded that there exist signal to be modulated. It is a low frequency signal. There exist high frequency carrier wave. After amplitude modulation, we get resulted modulated wave, whose modulation is going to depend upon modulation index, which is the ratio of EM upon EC or E maximum, EC maximum minus E minimum upon E maximum plus E minimum into 100, that is in percentage. That modulated wave is in the form of the fact that the amplitude of the carrier wave changes as the amplitude of signal to be transmitted varies or changes. So that is the representative modulated waveform which we studied yesterday. We also studied the expanded equation of amplitude modulated wave, and from that we studied the frequency spectrum of amplitude modulated wave. In frequency spectra, we studied that frequency spectra of amplitude modulated wave is a representative aspect of three components. One is the carrier wave having the maximum amplitude, that is EC. Second one is the lower sideband having the frequency FC minus FM and amplitude MA into EC upon 2. Third component is upper sideband having the frequency FC plus FM and amplitude equal to MA into EC upon 2. So thus we can say amplitude modulated wave forms the lower sideband, upper sideband that contains the signal information, and now today we are going to consider how power is distributed in amplitude modulated wave. Friends, to study the power distribution in the amplitude modulated wave, that concludes you which band is responsible to communicate. No doubt, power is essential to transmit the signal from transmitter towards the receiver. But simple power, more power doesn't help if the signal to be communicated is not present in that. This is same as that of a healthy person is there, which has more power, more strength, so that person is going to move from one place to another place very easily. But he doesn't have a signal. He don't know how to communicate with each other. Then his strength is not useful. If strengthened man carries the information, carries the signal along with him from transmitter to the receiver, from one person to the another person, so that the perfect and satisfactory communication it is going on. So that's why power distribution along with the existence of signal plays the very vital role in amplitude modulation. As you have studied the frequency spectrum, that at the center there is a carrier spectrum vector representation. On the lower side, there is a lower sideband. On the upper side, there is upper sideband. We are considering the lower sideband, upper sideband, and the carrier wave to undergo, to study the distribution of the power after performing the amplitude modulation in the transmitter. To study that, let me consider expanded amplitude modulated wave, which I already studied in the mathematical analysis of amplitude modulation. And that equation is represented as E mod, that is modulated equation consisting three components. One is ECM sine of omega ct, it is a carrier wave. MA into ECM upon 2 cos of omega c minus omega mt, it is lower sideband. MA into ECM upon 2 cos of omega c plus omega mt, it is the upper sideband. This equation represents the extended form of modulated equation. Let me call this equation as equation number 1. This equation is in the form of voltage, E for EMF, E for voltage, MOD for modulated. It is modulated voltage is given by equation 1. If suppose this signal voltage, modulated signal, is fed to resistance of 1 ohm. When this voltage is applied to the resistance of 1 ohm, then across that 1 ohm, we are going to calculate the power. So after applying this particular signal voltage to the resistance of 1 ohm, the average power in each component of wave is a square of RMS value of concerned component. Because it is a varying signal, therefore we are going to consider the RMS value. RMS means root mean square value of the voltage. It's a square. Actually, what is the formula for power? Power, it is a V square upon R. That is the power. And here R is 1 ohm. Therefore, power is equal to V square. So, to calculate the power, what it is told here, the average power in each component of wave, each component means from this component, from carrier wave, from lower sideband, from upper sideband, from each component, the power is square of RMS value of the amplitude or voltage present in respective signal. If you sum all of them, you will get the modulated voltage or modulated signal, power in that particular way. Now let us calculate by this particular formula power through the carrier wave. So this is the carrier wave component which we have studied last derivation. So therefore power through this particular, in frequency spectra, carrier wave is represented at the center having the amplitude ECM. Therefore ECM is the highest voltage amplitude. That's why the power through that particular carrier wave is given as ECM square upon 2. Basically, RMS value is ECM upon root 2. It's square. We can get it as ECM square upon 2. Let me call this as equation number 1. RMS value is amplitude upon root 2. That is the root mean square voltage. If you square it, you can get it ECM square upon square of root 2. It is 2. So accordingly, we can say power through carrier wave, it is square of this upon 2, where ECM is peak amplitude of the carrier wave. Already we know very well about that. Similarly, power in sideband is sum of the power in lower side band and also the sum of the power in upper side band. For lower component, lower side band, amplitude is MA into ECM upon 2. Its RMS value is MA into ECM upon 2 root 2. For both the cases, and its square and their sum. So accordingly we can say MA into ECM upon 2 root 2 bracket square. It should be 2 root 2. This is the entire amplitude. It is to be divided by root 2, that we will get in RMS value. Try to remember here root 2 is missing. Try to consider that. Here also same case. This is for lower side band. This one is for upper side band. Here is also MA into ECM upon 2 root 2 bracket square. So MA into ECM square upon 2 root 2 square. 2 square 4, root 2 square 2. 2 into 4, it is 8. It is correct one. Same is true with this. Therefore, we can write it MA square ECM square upon 8. What is missing here? Once again, I will repeat. MA into ECM upon 2 root 2. It is missing in both the cases. Why root 2? It is RMS value for RMS. Its square, we can get it MA square ECM square upon 8 plus MA square ECM square upon 8. If you sum it, we can get it 2 into MA square ECM square upon 8. 2 to the 2 and the 1, 2 4 the 8. So that's why we can get it MA square into ECM square upon 4. This is the power in both the side band. What it represents? This is the power in both the side bands, means in lower side band and upper side band. Both side band contains the power that's equal to MA square into ECM square upon 4. It is represented by equation 3. Whereas a power in carrier wave is represented by ECM square upon 2, that is given by equation number 2. Total power in entire modulated wave is given as total power is equal to PC plus power in sideband. That is power in carrier wave plus power in sideband. Power in carrier wave is ECM square upon 2. Power in sideband is MA square up into ECM square upon 4. From this entire equation, take ECM square upon 2 common. If you take ECM square upon 2 common, we can write it as 1 plus MA in MA square upon 2. This is called as equation number 4. ECM square upon 2 into 1 plus MA square upon 2 is the total power in the modulated wave. This is the power in carrier wave. This is the power in sideband. Whereas equation 4 represents the total power in the modulated wave, which can also be written as PT, total power, is equal to ECM square upon 2. According to equation number 2, it is power in carrier wave. So that's why PT is equal to PC into bracket 1 minus MA square upon 2. That is equation number 5. Equation number 5 represents the total power in the modulated wave. PT is the total power. PC is the power in carrier wave into 1 plus MA square upon 2. Now we have calculated power in all the components. So this is power in carrier wave represented by equation 2. This is power in sideband represented by equation 3. Equation 4 represents the total power, which is sum of power in carrier wave plus sum of plus power in sideband, which is written in simplified form as PT is equal to PC into 1 minus MA square upon 2. It is, let me call this as equation number 5. Now dividing equation 3 by 4. Equation 3 is here. Divide this 3 equation by 4 so as to get power inside band upon total power is equal to power inside band is ECM square upon 2 into bracket 1 minus M square upon 2. Power inside band MS square into ECM square upon 4 to be divided by this equation. We can write it in reverse order, that is 1 plus, instead of dividing, I can multiply it with the reciprocal form, that is 1 plus M square upon 2 upon ECM square upon 2. So ECM square, ECM square cancels. And we can get simplified equation as here. PSB upon PT is equal to MS square upon 2 into bracket 1 plus MS square upon 2, ECM square, ECM square cancels. Which one can try to take this MS square upon 2 inside the bracket so that we can write it MS square by 2 plus MS square. If you put MA is equal to 1, that is the modulation index equal to 1, provided that there is 100% modulation, then equation 5 becomes PSB upon PT equal to MA is equal to 1, 1 square it is 1, 1 upon 2 plus 1 square it is 1. 1 plus half, it is 1 by 3. So PSB upon PT is equal to 1 by 3. That is, power in side band is equal to 1/3 power total power. What it indicates? It indicates that power in side band is 1/3 total power. Means in side band, in both the side bands, including, only 1/3 power is present. Conversely, we can say 2/3 power is present in the carrier wave. This means that if suppose 100% is the total power, then 33% power is present in side band and 66% power is present in both the side bands, in the carrier wave. This gives a very important aspect regarding the power distribution, that is, power in both the sideband is 1/3 total power. In conversely, we can say 2/3 power is present in the carrier wave. But in the carrier wave, no signal is present. Entire signal is present only in the sideband. But in sideband, less power is present. More power is present in the carrier wave, that is 2/3 power, whereas less power is present in the sideband. In carrier wave, no signal is present, but in sideband, signal is present. Therefore, only sidebands are required to be transmitted from transmitter towards the receiver. This means that for modulation index equal to 1, 100% modulation, only 1/3 of total power is in the sideband, both the sidebands, and remaining 2/3 power is in the carrier wave. So most of the power is present in the carrier wave, less power is present in the sideband. As carrier doesn't contain any signal, AM has only 1/3 useful power, 2/3 power we are going to waste it. Means the power which is present in the carrier wave, we are going to waste it. What is useful power? Useful power is only 1/3 power because signal is present only in the sideband. With the help of 1/3 power only, one can transmit the signal from transmitter towards the receiver. That's why we can say AM has only 1/3 useful power. Generally, modulation index lies between 0.3 to 0.5 and useful power becomes 4.3 to 11% of total power. If for 0.3, it is 4.3%. for 0.5, it is 11%. That particular amount of power is going to be gets useful. Again, I will repeat. Sideband contains the signal, but it has only 1/3 of the total power, which is useful. But carrier wave contains 2/3 power, but it doesn't have any signal. Hence, if carrier wave is transmitted, it is going to be wasted, waste of the power. So that's why in most of the communication techniques, carrier wave is suppressed, which we are going to study in forthcoming topics, in forthcoming articles. As a being, useful power is only 1/3. Only sidebands are used to communicate carrier by suppressing the carrier wave. And that we are going to study under the study of concept of double sideband, concept of single sideband, and also the concept of vestigial sideband. Either by using a DSB technique, either by using SSB technique. DSB means double sideband, SSB means single sideband, VSB means vestigial sideband. The signal is going to be communicated if it is amplitude modulated wave from transmitter towards the receiver. Friends, that's all about how power is distributed in the amplitude modulated wave, and how much amount of power is useful and how much amount of power it is going to be wasted during the amplitude modulated communication process. Dear students, next time we'll go for concept of DSB, SSB and also the VSB. Today we'll stop. Next time, once again, we'll meet for the next lecture.